Get ready to match the stars. Jim Backus, Rhett Summers, Nipsey Russell, Patty Deutsch, Richard Dawson, and Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there. Thank you, Johnny Olson. Thank you.
How are you doing?
How do you do, group?
We do well.
Very well.
Good. You look grand.
Thank you.
Are you all prepared?
We're prepared.
Have a go at this?
Yep. Yes.
Okay.
Take a little tug at it.
All right. We'll have a little tug at it. Let's say hello to our two players, Kathy Miner and Myron Nisley here. Myron is a current champ. He's won $700. He's got two games to his credit, and he is being challenged by Kathy Miner, whom we met at the close of last session. What did we find out about you? You're a school teacher.
No, my husband is.
Oh, your husband's a school
teacher. I'm gonna be.
You're gonna be. Okay. Well, we'll start this game right from the top, right after we pass along these messages to you. Here we go. Brand new game coming up here. I push the button, reveal two things there, and Kathy, you're the challenger. You make a selection.
A.
A is what she wants. Everybody plays.
Everybody.
You got it, baby.
Thanks. Snow White said. Actually, there was an eighth dwarf. She said, but we kept him hidden because he was blank. Snow White said, actually, there was an eighth dwarf, but we kept him hidden because he was blank.
Why would you hide a dwarf?
All right. Now, they're all finished. So, Kathy, it's up to you to give us an answer. Snow White said, actually, there was an eighth dwarf, but we kept him hidden because he was...
Oh, gee. Ugly.
Ugly. She says ugly. An ugly dwarf.
I never saw
an ugly dwarf.
Never in my life. No.
All right.
Never saw one I didn't like.
I never met a dwarf I didn't like. Then.
But I said
a midget?
I said normal.
Normal. He was tall, so they had to hide him.
Right.
How could you call him a dwarf and live in that family?
Yes.
All right. What a fantasy life you must have. Brett, what do you say?
Well, actually, he kept him hidden because he developed a deep sense of inferiority because he was very tall.
Tall dwarf.
That's right.
A 4'8" dwarf. What do you say?
Young lady, Nipsey? Kathy Miner is not all bad, because I went down and I said, sneezy, dope, ugly.
Ugly.
Oh, my God.
So you've got one there, Kathy. Let's see if you get one from Patty Deutsch.
Oh, I thought the eighth dwarf's name would be Dirty.
Dirty. You dirty little dwarf.
Yeah.
Get back in the closet. What do you say?
Well, they got rid of him because he was too tall.
Too tall. That's why they hit him.
Poor little devil.
Ugly is the answer Kathy's looking for. Betty White, what do you have to offer?
Nothing. Not a blinking thing. I had Wiggy. You know, Wiggy the dwarf.
Wiggy. Does it say Wiggy on your card? It says Wiggy on her card.
Wiggy? Witchy put.
Send this girl to camp.
I'll settle for having her leave the building.
Are you ready?
All right.
Everybody plays, and this is Myron's question. Listen carefully, one and all. Tarzan said to Jane.
I refuse. It's not fair.
How many times I tell you, do not blank loincloth?
Not Jewish.
Tarzan said, how many times I tell you, do not blank my loincloth? Tarzan is speaking.
I thought you did it beautifully.
Thank you. I mean, it wasn't Jane.
Alienated a lot of people, but there.
All right.
I'm ready.
Ready over there. Ready over here. What do you say to that, Myron? Tarzan say to Jane, how many times I tell you, do not blank my loincloth?
Wash.
Do not wash my loincloth?
Wash.
Gave me Tarzan.
Yeah.
Me.
Back to the dirty talk.
Oh,
no wonder the animals didn't attack. What do you say?
I know you
me?
Admire
yeah,
right
you.
Now.
Me?
You
say? I
you,
say, Jim, I what? Say starch.
Starch.
Any.
Starch, right.
Oh,
oh yeah. Ah. Oh, boy, very bad starch.
Very bad.
Irritate the heck out of you.
What I wish I were anywhere but here.
Here
I
you
said
are.
Iron. Do not, I neither
do not
wash
iron.
Nor iron or none of that.
Nothing.
What do you mean, bleh?
That means no match. Wash
iron
is his answer.
Iron.
What's yours, Nipsey?
Tarzan told Jane, just cause we not married, don't tell boy he adopted.
Starch.
Starch.
Give
me
the answer.
Starch.
That's what he said.
Don't put any starch.
All right, what
soft
do you
garlic.
See? What are you peeking at there, Patty?
Oh, well, I figured Tarzan was very modest, so he told her not to snitch his loincloth.
Do not snitch.
Yeah, it isn't nice.
Well, yeah, so
I
far,
have
do not snitch, do not starch. I don't know, whether we call on him or not there. What do you
yes,
say?
Yes, do not starch loincloth.
Not
when me fall over, break starch. To pieces.
Yes.
Indecent exposure, not good. Freak animals out.
Speak.
Do not starch.
Do not starch.
Better than wicked.
So we got a lot of starch there, and no match for you, Myron, because of the answer you gave us. Now it's 1-0 at the end of round two. We go to at the end of round one, rather. We go to round two, and Kathy asks you to make a selection.
A.
A. Last time around, you matched Nipsey's. So now everyone but Nipsey will do this.
Everyone but Nipsey.
George Washington said to Betsy Ross.
I wouldn't want to be in that.
He said,
with the wooden teeth.
With his teeth clicking. Uh-huh. If that flag isn't ready by the 4th of July, we're going to run your blank up the pole. You can listen, as long as you're having so much fun, you can write an answer just
okay.
for me. Just you and me. I'll play a little game here with you.
All right.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
I see that.
All right.
Yes, I got it. Very good. Very amusing.
There's no linings.
No.
All right. Everybody ready? Okay. Here we go. How do you respond to this, Kathy? George Washington said to Betsy Ross, if that flag isn't ready by the 4th of July, we're going to run your blank up the pole.
Underwear.
Underwear. Yards and yards of them in those days,
riddle.
Didn't they? 9 yards of petticoats and all that.
Oh.
What do you say, Jim?
I said Fanny.
That was her sister's name.
That was her sister, Fanny, yeah. We had her on the show last week, Fanny Flagg. You all remember that? That's her. Fanny Flagg. folks, you got it. Thanks a lot. These young kids, boy, they're right with it there. You older folks. What do you say?
I'm glad you didn't do that to the second tier. Older folks. Well, yes, that's true about her,
all
poor
right.
little devil.
Hold your card up there.
She asked, you know what her pseudonym is?
What?
Betsy Ross.
Really?
Your rump.
Rump. Okay.
Your all fanny right. flag?
Yeah.
Or your rump flag?
Or anything you say, dear. All right.
Your rump roast. You're going to take a dinner and run it up.
Now it's time for Patty Deutsch here.
I said run her drawers up the...
Drawers! Drawers.
Out loud
you don't hear that too much.
No.
George Washington would have said drawers, wouldn't he?
Yeah.
What do you say, Richard?
George Washington would have said, how about it?
You should probably know him, Brad. Could be the last
of would you get on with it?
Yes, yes. Yeah, we've got to because she's got to be back in Synanon in an hour.
Run your dress up the pole.
That is not a Polish joke.
No, we can't do that.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, okay. What do you say?
We'll run your dress up the pole and see if anybody salutes you.
Right. Yeah.
What do you say, Elizabeth?
Kathy, you have two matches, and you've got to finish your round. But before we get to you, we've got to get to this, so stick around. Okay, here we go with the second half of round two. And it's 2-0. Now, you've got to score twice to stay in the game. However, if you match three celebrities, you will win your third game. Ready?
Yes.
Here we go.
May I play this time?
Are we?
Everybody plays.
Everybody.
Everybody
Nobody
plays.
Lays out?
When Robert got home...
What?
When Robert got home...
Yes.
He was shocked to find that his pet snake had eaten his blank. Pat Snake had eaten his blank. I'm not gonna look. I'm gonna stick over here with
Robert
the same
got
folk.
Home, eh?
Yes.
The old?
When he got home, he walked into the door.
The old, yeah.
I used to be married to Robert.
Really? Not this one. Nipsey, what are you doing up there?
Oh, I was drawing a picture of Robert.
All right, now he's ready. So, Myron, we call on you. When Robert got home, he was shocked to find that his pet snake had eaten his...
wife.
Wife.
I told you he was cute.
Yes. Wife, he said.
Wife, yes.
Yeah,
yes.
That really surprises me. Does
it surprise
me, you?
Yes.
What did you say?
You think he's sick? How about me?
Wife!
Oh. Something Freudian going on.
All right, there's one there. You need one more to tie. Two will win it. Let's see if it happens. Brett.
It's Jack Klugman's dream of glory. Wife.
That ties the score. One more, and you'll win another game. Let's see what Mitzi has.
Well, you see, he kept him with all of his pets, and actually, that snake ate Robert's bird.
Okay. Well, what did the snake know? Patty, what do you say?
Well, actually, it's a little-known fact that snakes are notorious wife-eaters.
That wins the game. Congratulations. Okay, come around, man. We gotta see. Congratulations to you again. I was just amused at Richard Dawson's answer. His pet snake ate his mongoose. That's how I thought.
Like man bites dog. Snake eats mongoose.
All right, now Kathy, we've got. What have we got for Kathy? We got a gift for you. Together with our most sincere thanks for being with us here on Match Game 73.
Thank you.
Goodbye, Kathy. Shall we get right to it, Myron?
Here we go again.
All right. Stand right up here on this little hunk of tape they glued to the ground. That's what that's for there. That's your mark. Stand there like that. That's right. Okay. I just don't want you to wander too far. I want you to be able to see everything clearly here. We polled a recent studio audience, Myron. We got their best response to this. A Turkish blank. Turkish blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you can match it. Second most frequent response, $250. Third, $100. Now, which three celebrities would you like to get a little help from?
I'll stay with Brett.
I'll bet you will.
If I have my way, he will. I'm going to say Turkish bath.
Turkish bath. One answer. Okay.
Patty.
Patty Deutsch.
Turkish taffy.
Turkish taffy. Okay. And one more.
Nipsey.
Turkish towel.
Turkish towel. So you've got Turkish bath, Turkish towel, Turkish taffy, and those are three answers. You can give us one of your own if you'd like, but we need an answer now.
I'll take Brett's answer. Bath.
Oh, here's more kissing.
Turkish bath is the one he chose, and that's the one we are looking for, and we're going to see if it's up here. First, under the $100 response, Turkish taffy. Oh, that was Patty's answer. That's up there. All right, that may be a good omen, Myron. Who knows? Looking for Turkish bath, here is the $250 response.
Turkish
towel. That was Nipsey's. That's up there. Third and last chance to get a Turkish bath. All together, let's look at the $500 response. Bath!
Yay!
That's so scary, little
kid. Pass
you by, Jim. Jim Backus got hurt in the kissing stampede there. Was it worth it?
Well, it was kind of quick, and I had to run fast.
That's life, Myron. All right. You've got the $500. That means you'll now play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. To collect the amount, you must match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis, and it has to be an exact match. Please choose a celebrity now.
Brett.
Okay.
Don't even know.
She is a better kisser than you think she is. You know how I love it when you choose Dickie
Dawson.
All right. Oh, Brett, get ready to write. You face me, if you would, please, sir. Here is the $5,000 question. Brett, please write your answer to this. Blank house. Blank house.
Oh, yeah.
Or blank house. Okay, now she is finished. Myron, you give us your response to this, if you would, please. Blank house.
Bath.
Bath house. Okay, for $5,000, Brett, may we see your answer. His is bathhouse.
I said, what?
White House.
That was the other one I was toying with.
You thought of White House?
I thought of White House, but I looked at bathhouse and decided that would...
That was it. Okay, well, you both made a great try at it. We congratulate you both here. And you've got $1,300 to your credit. And we'll come back to you in a moment or so, Myron. But first, we've got a message for you. All right, here we go, folks. Are you all ready? Let's say hello to Susan Rayfield. Hello, Susan.
Hi.
Could you tell us a little bit about yourself, if you please?
I live in Granada Hills, California. I'm a housewife, mother, and carpooler to my two daughters.
Okay, good luck to you here, Susan. You know that you and Myron will be answering questions, trying to match the six kooks over here. And the one who does that most often at the end of the second round will be the winner and have a go at the super match, which you can win over $5,000. All right, some of our contestants find these some more difficult than the others. That's why we ask you to make a selection. Go.
A.
A is what she wants.
A.
A is what she wants.
Wow, what it was.
He's just writing rule things.
I see. All right. Marshall Dillon.
That's the big fella.
That's right. He's the big one.
The tall dwarf. Yeah.
That's right. Marshall Dillon takes Kitty to blank once a week.
What?
Marshall Dillon takes Kitty to blank once a week. All right. Jim's ready up there. Nipsey.
I'm ready.
Okay.
I just keep forgetting.
I'm Ready's brother.
All right, here we go. Susan, how do you fill this in? Marshall Dillon takes Kitty to...
I can only think of one answer, bed.
To bed.
It's Kitty to bed once a week.
Whether she wants to or not. Jim, what do you say to this?
I worked on that show next door for 4 years, and I said the church.
To church?
Yes.
All right, Brett, what do you say?
Why are you such a constant disappointment to me, Jim?
I don't know.
Well, I was going to say bed, but I'm so tired of being bleeped off CBS that I said dinner.
To dinner. Okay. Nipsey, what did you say?
Well, I won't tell you what they prayed for, but I agree, he took her to church.
Okay. All right, no match so far, Susan. Let's see how we do with Patty here.
I said that he took her to eat once a week.
Took her to lunch or dinner or something like that.
Feeding, yeah.
Yeah, all right.
Put on the old feedback.
Right. Yes. Richard.
He did actually take her to eat. I don't know if you know that the Marshall and Kitty are not quite all there. Hence the expression, they're out to lunch. Poor devils.
All right. Betty, are you going to match this lady or vice versa?
Neither one. They went to church.
Church. Okay. So, Myron, we'll get to your question right after we get to this, so you hurry back. All right, listen, we've got time, lots of time, but not enough to do another question. So you're going to have to just hold everything where it is and come back next time, all right? Look forward to seeing you, Susan and Myron, and look forward to seeing all of you.
Yes.
Pick a topic of discussion there.
I want to see a rerun of Marshall Dillon. That's what I do.
No, we're not doing that.
No?
No, we can't do that. What do you say then?
Oh, what do you want to talk about, Gene?
I want to talk about your TV activities there.
Oh.
And when, you know, we can see it?
Well, the one we did last night, the Mary Tyler Moore Show, will probably be on around the middle of November to the end of November, yeah. Somewhere in there, and it's a very funny show. Ted Baxter's marvelous on it, as is Mary.
He's and very good.
I'm still a happy hook, a homemaker.
Bleep. There.
Amazing. I've been here 30 minutes, and now I find out.
How do you think she got into showbiz?
Patty, what's the name of the show you're in? Or will be in?
The Girl with Something Extra.
The Girl with Something Extra.
Yes.
Right. Yes.
Of which I'm not one.
This girl has beautiful red hair.
Thank you. It matches my accent. Settle down.
I look forward to seeing you all of it next time. And Gene Rayburn here for Match Game 73. Thank you for joining us this time. Join us next time.
Today's consolation prizes are Clairol's four-way lighted mirror, so you can make up in the lights you'll be seen in. Clairol's four-way lighted mirror. And Clairol's three-way hair setter gives your curl more choices. Water mist, conditioning mist, or regular sets. Clairol's three-way hair setter. And Dark Eyes, the once-a-month eyelash and eyebrow makeup that won't run, smear, wash off, cream off, or even cry off. And a supply of Johnston's dessert topping. Heat the handy pouch, cut open and serve. Great on ice cream or cake from Johnston's. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.